the tickets. But please don't bring them downstairs after mass. I'm just staying long enough for the drawing and then come home and put them in. I love them.
Oh, yes. No, this Good morning. Please join us for opening of number 552, Glory and Praise to Our God. O God, creator and ruler of all things, that we may feel the working of your mercy, grant we may serve you with all our heart, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated. Everybody, we're supposed to forgive everybody.
about God's grace and God's love, and that sometimes we sin, and sometimes, and he always forgives us. So isn't that great stuff? So, I mean, Jesus is the Savior, so let's go forth and hear about the Word of God.
We're all wide awake this morning.
St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am grateful to him who has strengthened me, Christ Jesus our Lord, because he considered me trustworthy in appointing me to the ministry. I was once a blasphemer and a persecutor and arrogant, but I have been mercifully treated because I have acted out of ignorance in my unbelief. Indeed, the grace of our Lord has been abundant, along with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. The saying is trustworthy and deserves full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Of these, I am foremost. For that reason, I was mercifully treated, so that in me, as the foremost, Christ Jesus might display all his patience as an example for those who would come to believe in him for everlasting life. To the King of ages, incorruptible, invisible, the only God, honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
After a few days, the younger son collected all his belongings and set off to a distant
distant country, where he squandered his inheritance on a life of dissipation. When he had freely spent everything, a severe famine struck that country, and he found himself in dire need. So he hired himself out to one of the local citizens, who sent him to his farm to tend the swine. And he longed to eat his fill of the pods on which the swine fed, but nobody gave him any. Coming to his senses, he thought, "How many of my father's hired workers have more than enough food to eat? But here am I, dying from hunger. I shall get up and go to my father, and I shall say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son. Treat me as you would treat one of your hired workers.'" So he got up and went back to his father. While he was still a long way off, his father caught sight of him and was filled with compassion. He ran to his son, embraced him, and kissed him. His son said to him, "Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son." But his father ordered his servants, "Quickly, bring the finest robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Take the fat calf and slaughter it. Then let us celebrate with a feast, because this son of mine was dead and has come to life again. He was lost and has been found." Then the celebration began. Now the older son had been out in the field, and on his way back, as he neared the house, he heard the sound of music and dancing. He called one of the servants and asked what this might mean. The servant said to him, "Your brother has returned, and your father has slaughtered the fattened calf because he has him back safe and sound." He became angry, and when he refused to enter the house, his father came out and pleaded with him. He said to his father in reply, "Look, all these years I served you, and not once did I disobey your orders. Yet you never gave me even a young goat to feast on with my friends. But when your son returns, who swallowed up your property with prostitutes, for him you slaughtered a fat calf." He said to him, "My son, you are here with me always. Everything I have is yours. But now we must celebrate and rejoice, because your brother was dead and has come to life again. He was lost and has been found." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Good morning. I'm Dan Reilly. I'm a deacon assigned to St. Elizabeth's in Sept. I was here just about a year ago. I'm sure you all remember. Father Paul fought a first responder who used to live in New York City and had a brother who was a firefighter. Might have something different to say on Patriot Sunday. Now maybe it's a regular thing. Some interesting readings today. The Gospel is the longest Gospel reading except for some on Holy Week. And in the first reading we have the famous golden calf. Let's start with the golden calf. The reading is from Exodus, the story of the Israelites leaving Egypt. Everyone has seen or heard Moses telling Pharaoh, "Let my people go." Then there were plagues and the whole Egyptian army drowning in the Red Sea that the Israelites had crossed badly to get their feet wet. It's just a little while later. Moses, their leader, is up on the mountain hanging out with God. And the people have decided, in the absence of Moses, that their God is a golden calf they made. They've forgotten all the things God just did for them. It's craziness. It would be like cursing out the slow-moving driver in front of you as you're coming home from church. For the officers here, or ones who want to be, Moses gives an interesting leadership lesson today. God is willing to destroy the people he is leading and give them a new group that God hopes would be better. Moses sides with his people and pleads with God. title really misses the point. It's really the parable of the forgiving Father. The big message is forgiveness. It's the only parable where the God figure runs to offer his forgiveness. And it may be significant, especially these days, that the prodigal is a refugee, probably from a trap. But the Father's not interested in where the prodigal comes from. He's overjoyed about where he's coming, back to God for forgiveness. Today is Patriot Sunday. It's also Grandparents' Day and the 24th Sunday of Ordinary Time. A lot to do today. I'm not sure exactly what Patriot Sunday means. Words like patriot have taken some abuse lately. It was 21 years ago today that the attacks on the World Trade Center and the Pentagon occurred. A lot of us remember just where we were and what we were doing that day. Some of us here have no recollection of anything 21 years ago because we were too young or too old. As I mentioned last year, my brother was a New York City firefighter in 2001. He was not on the initial response, but he worked on the recovery at Ground Zero. I've been reminded of that lately, as all the cancer deaths among New York City firefighters, and that includes just about anyone who worked at Ground Zero, any of those who worked with him, all those deaths have been reclassified as line of duty deaths. That's a significant thing for a firefighter, particularly in New York City. So this Wednesday, I'm going to New York City Fire Department headquarters to see his plaque go on their wall of heroes. We look for lessons sometimes as we remember big events or read stories from the Bible. The lesson today is all about forgiveness. We'll all pray in a little while, forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Since we are all sinners, we all need to be forgiven. So we should all be forgiven. Also keep in mind that older brother. Don't be too quick to think someone else is getting more forgiveness than you are. When we say patriot, sometimes it brings up glorious images of war. Most of the time, though, war has made world way more losers than winners. It's hard to see how the current war in Ukraine will have any winners. The losers are all over. Just like the prodigal, there are many people hungry from drought and war, climate change and armed conflict. Today's lesson of forgiveness go a long way there. There's something to pray for. Also, an opportunity to implement last week's lesson about storing up treasures in heaven. We could use our earthly treasure to feed our brothers and sisters here on earth. Forgiveness and food. Sounds like heaven.
ascended into heaven, to see the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, as spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. Look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Hearing the word of God, we offer our petitions at this time.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For all leaders and ministers of the church, that they may search out and welcome with compassion all who have become estranged or misdirected on their life journey. We pray. Lord, hear our prayer. For peace, that God will turn hearts from violence and terrorism, protect the innocent from harm, and bring forth a new season of justice and peace. We pray. For those affected by the 9/11 attacks, that God will shepherd them and be a compassionate presence to those who are grieving. We pray. For all first responders, firefighters, police, search and rescue, ambulance CMTs, veterans, and active members of the military, that God will protect them from harm and continue to bless them in all the challenges they may face. We pray. For our local community, especially residents and staff of Guy and Mary Fell Manor, we pray. For all young people beginning faith formation programs, that the Spirit of God will touch their hearts and open their minds to the gospel message this year. We pray.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all our grandparents, Lord, bless them for all the love and care they have shared with us over the years. We pray.
Lord,
for our community churches, especially for Reverend James Eastman and the members of Eber Waters, we also pray for Father Felix and the members of San Antonio, our sister parishes in the Yucatan, that the Spirit of God will renew them and guide them in God's service. We pray.
Lord.
For our beloved deceased, especially our grandparents and those who sacrificed the most on September 11, 2001, and for Edgar Hedlund Jr., father of Christopher Heitland, who passed away recently, and for James Grimone, who we remember in a special way at this liturgy, and for all who have died recently, may they experience the love and mercy of Jesus and rest in his heavenly peace. We pray.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For any special intentions you may wish to voice. We pray.
Lord.
Special prayer blessings for our first responders. Lord, your blessings upon them, give them your grace, give them your protection. And when they're in their harmful states, protect them and keep them. When they're in times of helping and serving people, may they do the best of their ability and with the greatest attention and care. Reward them for the things they do for us and let them know we appreciate and care for them. Give them your grace and give them especially the gift of eternal life. God's blessings upon you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. If we do one more thing, it's time for grandparents. Would you please stand? Your grandparents, please stand. Special grandparents today. Oh, look, we got the kids coming. All right, we're going to have a special blessing for grandparents, so come on up. I hope you have some of your grandparents here with you. I think you do. All right. I bet you some of you others are grandparents too. Okay. Lord's blessing on all the grandparents today on this special day for them. We're very thankful.
We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Blessings upon you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Oh,
of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you, for men, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Thank you.
Manner situation, our prayers in our hearts with everybody in the Felt Manor and the residents and
employees. And so every Wednesday at 6:30, every Wednesday at 6:30, we will have a special rosary for them, praying for their well-being, God take care of them, and all that. So Wednesday at 6:30, until further notice, we'll be praying for Guy and Clary, Mary, Delta, Mary. So next Sunday begins a formally called religious education and the experience, especially for 6th through 9th graders, called Edge. It's going to happen right after Mass, and it's a very wonderful opportunity for all of our 6th through 9ers, finance all of our grades, and also benefits our adults. We've had God been getting benefiting from grants lately, and they are from the diocese and from the Catholic Education Collection. We've got books from the lending library. We've got the year subscription to form.org for all kinds of things that are faith-based TV things and for your apps. And then also we got a grant now, a new grant for larger screen televisions in our classrooms. And again, these are all the next collection next week. Thanks. Okay, parish council will be on Tuesday at 4:30. And then also downstairs, there's breakfast, all that. And we will also draw the raffle tickets we've been holding on to since Memorial Day. We'll get some win to find out who our winners are from those raffles downstairs. Everyone, please join us downstairs.
Our Sunday fourth hymn is number 379, Send Forth Thy God's Blessing.
The Lord be with you.